What up people, JIB here again. Today I once again have another video for you guys, so I'm going to be vlogging today and just got home. I went to work with my mum and we were cleaning houses and stuff because that's what my mum does. But now I'm just going to get ready, have breakfast, and soon Knuckles is going to be over. He's going to be vlogging as well because he's starting a channel soon and he's trying to get a whole bunch of videos so that when he does have his channel he doesn't have to like worry about the videos. You could just upload. Like, if you notice with me, I upload every morning, unless obviously the internet mucks me around. But that's what his aim is to do, so he doesn't have to go out and film every day. He's able to like have a whole bunch of content, and then it's already edited, and he can just upload it, which is actually a really good strategy. But yeah, so he's gonna be over soon. For now, I'm just gonna get ready. You'll see me in different clothes, and this clip will probably be whatever it is, but most likely gonna be me hanging out with him. Knuckles has just arrived, and I'm about to have some brekkie, and yeah, he's vlogging today as well, so double vlogging.
Yeah, double vlogging.
And we're gonna try
thing here.
Oh yeah, both yeah, using phones.
Fisheye. I dropped it today, but then I realized that's an iPhone 4, and so it doesn't break.
Oh no, they're like tough. Like the sixes and stuff, they're pretty delicate though.
Yeah, so jeez. Pieces of paper, that's what they're made out of.
Yeah, they're really thin.
Yeah.
But yeah, we're gonna try and get some clips. We're working on a few projects, so we'll try and get them down today. So we are now leaving home, gonna go to Pine Hill, and I'm gonna attempt the 5-stair. If it doesn't go down today, we'll be going down tomorrow because I'm chilling with Knuckles tomorrow as well. But for now, we're gonna go to Pine Hill, warm up, try the 5-stair, and then we'll go to the warehouse to get some equipment for the skit I'm working on. Who did this? Who's king of this spot? No, I'm not king of the spot, but who did that last? So we're now at Pine Hill. I'm about to do the 5-stair. It should be dry. My grip tape is muddy. And James is fucking up to! But yeah, mud all over my grip tape from walking through the mud. My shoes are insanely slippery at the moment, but we're shoe good. So it's gonna be hard to kick flip in this, but you know me, I'm always doing stuff in the worst conditions ever. There is literal dirt all over my shoe, but I'm gonna try this and you guys will get to see my attempts. And yeah. So we're now leaving Pine Hill on the way to the warehouse. He's gone now, he's down there. But that kid, Simon, kept interrupting. Well, I'm trying to skate. As soon as I'm about to pop, he just looks at me like this and does the Rubik's Cube where he just, oh, do you know this? And it's like, bro, I'm trying to do something here, man. Stop trying to psych me out. It's just frustrating. But one of the attempts, I think I got pretty close. There's one of the attempts where I did the splits. We didn't record it on my phone, recorded it on James's. But if you want to see it, how's it going, dudes? If you want to see that. Pardon?
No.
Yeah.
Yeah. I didn't record that.
Didn't you?
No.
I got the camera. Hey!
Are they your mates? What? I'm so confused.
There, guys. Cause
wait, what did all the time do?
Driving. Oh, right. You see how you got the white line there?
Yeah.
They were over the white line on the other guy's side of the road. So, lucky you had this bit here because the other guy had to drive on this bit because they were taking up the whole road. But they looked at us and, like, smiled and, like, and I was like, hey. And I just waved. And he's like, is that your friends? Because I waved. I was just being friendly. Got some bugs.
Vroom,
vroom. Vroom, 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 vroom. Oh, that helmet. Helmet on point, dude. But,
he's wearing Adidas as well.
Is he? Oh, fuck. Alright, I'm just gonna walk because my shoes are slippery as fuck. I think I got my wallet in my bag. Gonna go get the props. And, next thing will be us in the warehouse. And it will probably be like quite a few. Maybe an hour after where I am now. You'll see a clip will be an hour from now because obviously I'm going to try and get the artsy shots and shit for the skit. But it's going to be a dumb skit with Jack and should be good. We just stopped off at the crib, got something to drink and Mum gave me some money so I can go get something to eat for brekkie. But this lady was driving past in the car. Today's been such a weird day, by the way. But this lady was driving past in the car. The man was driving past in the car. Her girlfriend was in the back and she's just like this. She looked at me and she's like, like as if she's choking by my dick, like deep throating. I was like, What are you on, dude? It's like such a weird day, but right now on the way to the warehouse, shoot some shit there. Should be good.
Something weird happens at the
warehouse. Something will. It's already a weird day.
Manual pad.
Oh, that's metal as well. Oh, that's some slippery shit. We are now at Westfield Mall. We'll go in the mall. We'll look around, but we're gonna also go to North Beach and stuff since we've got the whole day free pretty much until 3 o'clock, and it's only like 11 or something now. We're just gonna go look around, just enjoy the day, chillax, and yeah, Knuckles is over there vlogging, so am I, both doing what we love, skating, filming, and editing, so it's gonna be a good day. And we're gonna see if we can ollie in the elevator. Fuck.
Oh, this thing is stuck in this elevator. Oh, it feels so weird.
It feels so weird because while it's going down. Alright, so now I can say I'm ollieing in an elevator. People were looking at us when we came out.
We were vlogging as we come out. We're like hopping off our skateboards and we have
I was still on the board when we got out, dude. At least we could say we ollied in an elevator now.
That was funny.
Well, first for everything. That's one off the bucket list.
Yeah.
Now we're in JB High Five. We just went to Amazon and stuff. Forgot to update, but just looking at some camera equipment for the future. Last time I got told off for skating around the mall, but the guy who told me off was a dickhead, so fuck you, I'm skating here anyway. Just walked up at BK. Gonna go get some brunch, breakfast/lunch. And yeah, I'll probably get a sunbill or something.
My grip tape is so fucking dirty.
Yeah, same.
He goes in mall grabs, and he's walking out mall grabs and thinking that he's a beast. And
cheeseburger, stunner, milk, caramel sundae, and
Jack was over there filling up his thing, and he mouthed me.
And I'm like, oh, grab it!
Cracking up, laughing. I was like,
holy shit!
There's this guy. He had like really grip, fresh as creature board, like all the trucks and stuff. He had the bones. You know the ones which lock into grinds and shit.
Yeah.
Wheels. They look like they were 56 or 55.
Big, good, trendy skating ones.
I looked at his wheels because they were had a blue and white graphic, and he had bearings, and they were white. And I'm pretty sure they were bone ceramics.
Shit.
And the grizzly grip tape, which is the blue one, which is like $18. Then he had the
spoiled
creature
rich
there.
Rich boy, these boys.
So he would have started off skateboarding. His parents would have gotten something good, and he walks out and just more grabs. And he's in like all the skater gear. Straight up poser. The way he did it. It seems like he's a poser, but.
Yeah, he was definitely a poser.
If he's starting out, then it's alright, but it looked like he was a poser. Yo, dude, have some fries, man.
Oh, yo, cheers.
I was gonna film me ordering, but the guy there was new. This didn't give me much for the sundae. All finished, all done.
Yummy, yummy.
Now we're gonna
thanks,
go to
Jack,
the
for the thingies.
You're welcome, dude. Now we're gonna go to the warehouse, then North Beach, and maybe Noel Leeming and Rebel Sports. But for now, we're just gonna look around, just have a good day, and get the props. Going through the warehouse now. About to film the skit. Gonna be good. Bro, we are gonna be skating these. 50. Yeah, try these out, dude.
No, I had these.
We get size 12.
I remember having these.
They got like $20 ones over there, but we got to get the shittiest ones we can find. So, get these, size 12.
Oh, yeah, so it's in between us.
Yes, in between us, because I'm size 13. Your size, what are you?
Like 11.
11, so it's in between, so it should be good for both of us. Dude, these are going to be sick. That's it. I wonder how long these will last. Like 5 minutes? Less? Maybe. Oh, our grip tape's not new, so it should probably last. But if you had fresh grip tape.
True.
No, thank you.
When they go into battle.
Is it like literal road cycling? That looks like something along border.
Time trials.
That looks like something along border.
So when you're just by yourself, that's what you wear, so you can get as aerodynamic as possible.
Wait, you know that like the armor shit? Oh, these are the gloves I'm getting, by the way. Purple.
Oh yeah. So we're currently in.
Now we are going through no laming, and I'm gonna try and find a tripod for my phone. So that's what we're looking for at the minute. No laming. James is very occupied.
The hell?
Playing Ratchet and Clank. I haven't played Ratchet and Clank in years, dude.
I haven't played it in ages, though.
PS4. I love a PS4, but it's so damn expensive.
Yeah.
And I wouldn't really use it that much because I don't really sit down for long.
My dad might be getting one soon.
Wow, lucky you.
Suck it. Bam, bam. Watch this, going for the melee. Dodge them bullets.
Oh, legend. That Fisher and Paykel stand over there. And they've got like a cooking bench and stuff. When they first released that, they had a camera crew and stuff, and they I got to cook because I was in food extension for North Cross, because I was in quite a few extension classes because it's me. But I was in food extension, and only three people from the whole school got to come. I came here, got to cook on that when it was brand new, when it first came out, and I got to cook with the winner of MasterChef. I forgot his name now. He had glasses.
Shit, really?
Yep, really. I told you I was good at school in North Cross. Only three people got to go, and I was one of them.
I did fuck all in my intermediate.
Jeez.
I did nothing.
And they had a thing, which Sophie did yesterday. It was called Fun Run. I didn't get to do the Fun Run, because what you have to do is you have to raise sponsors and shit, and then go run in the mud and stuff.
Oh, yeah?
Instead, because I was in architecture extension, I got to go on a school trip to an architecture thing in the city, and I got to have free pizza and stuff.
Lucky.
And it just pays off to be in extension class. I got offered for art extension and biotech extension, but I took down the office because I was already occupied with my other extension classes.
Did you buy what you want?
Yeah.
Cool.
Got a tripod. So we're on the way to North Beach now. We just left No Laming. Leaving North Beach now. Heading over to... it's going to definitely rain on us. If it does, we can do it under shelter.
Yeah.
On the way home, I'm going to go film the skit. The next clip will be us preparing for the skit, or... once the skit is done, but it's a dumb skit with Jack because that has been very, very popular on my channel. People keep requesting it, so that's what I'm doing. And leave in the comments below what videos you want to see more of, because they're the ones I'm going to do more of. Looking at the gloves here, and they have padding.
They're pretty dope, bro!
They've got padding in them, though, which is awesome. But we're about to film the skit. We're at Pine Hill now, getting ready, getting our equipment ready, and about to do this. I'm home now. Unfortunately, my phone died on us, and we were unable to complete the skit, so I'm going to be doing the outro for that, like, in a minute, but you guys won't see it, obviously, because it'll be for the skit, but, Knuckles has gone home, and I ended up opening my gloves earlier on. These, they're pretty tight, actually. I got them in large, because that was the biggest size they had. They're pretty tight, but they got padding here, which is really good, and it's just a suede and stuff there, which is really, really good. It seems airy, but I'm going to open, Seagull mini tripod, and you guys will see my first impression on the Seagull mini tripod.
That's pretty heavy. Damn, it's not that big. It's obviously hand size for me because I got big hands. But let's open this up. Damn. I can adjust it like this. I can turn it like that. Pretty good. Seagull, they do really good products, actually. I got this from No Laming. Has a bit on there, so I'm getting a mount either tonight or tomorrow night for this. This is pretty good metal, man. Jeez. But it's quite heavy, which is good, because you want some weight to this. But this is going to be awesome, because my phone will sit on this because I film with my phone, and you guys will be like that, and it won't be as shaky as it usually is. So I'll be getting a mount tonight or tomorrow night. Should be pretty good, and really stoked on this, and stoked on the gloves as well, because I got a mountain bike. Need to be able to have some gloves for mountain biking, and every time I fall on the skateboard I need gloves, so got some gloves. So use these for two things, and they've got padding for when I hit my hands, which is amazing. These actually went down
from $37 to $10 because the shop I got them from is closing down. But yeah. Soon, Sang Ho's gonna be over here. Well, not soon. Later on, Sang Ho's gonna be over here and I'll be like hanging out with him. He hasn't told me what time he's coming over, he just told me he's coming over. But I told him at 4:30, I have to drop Sophie to a friend's house because. What are you doing at a friend's house?
I'm having a sleepover.
Oh, having a sleepover.
I'm going to jump.
Oh, you're gonna jump? Yeah. Ooh, you gotta jump, jump, jump. Jump is like a place for the trampolines. And you just jump.
And there's like a foam pit, and like you can play dodgeball.
Dodgeball. Remember last time when I did the 360 dunk and I did the in between the legs dunk?
Yeah.
I did it in between the legs behind the back.
Yeah. Dunk. There's also like this basketball hoop thing.
Pretty balls, eh? Little brat. But she's gonna jump, dropping her off because it's sleepover at a friend's house. We'll be doing that at 4 o'clock or 4:30. We'll leave. Right now it's currently in 6 minutes it's going to be 3 o'clock, so we got an hour or hour and a half till we leave and go have lunch. Maybe go to Pine Hill and skate, if you don't mind, before we leave.
Okay.
Is it okay? Yeah, we'll go to Pine Hill and skate. I'll be skating later with Sang Ho. I haven't really done any skating today. I only like cruising around and the skit, but that's not proper skating. And Sophie's shaking the whole bed.
Sorry.
But yeah, like my mini tripod?
Oh, it's lovely.
Yeah. Oh, my gloves. They're going to be huge on you. So... Oh, they are small. I mean, big.
Look how small that
huh?
is. Look.
Yeah, this is the packaging which those gloves came in. It says, why ride? Well, why not?
So, when we were at North Beach, we got a little booklet magazine thing, and it's got a whole bunch of Vulcans. Whoa. I just realised Alex Midler is right there. I don't know who he read for Volcom. Damn, I didn't know Alex Midler wrote for Volcom. But they've got pretty cool posters in there. I'll show you some more. But I'll probably cut these out and make a collage. I've got other magazines there. I'll either add this to that pile or like cut the posters out. Originally I was going to make a collage, but now I might just cut the posters out. But yeah. If you guys are wondering what other magazines I've got,
oh, stack of them right there. Here's all my shoes. I got my Dixie Bridges, my first skate shoes. My West Crammers, the West Crammer SSEs. So they're the West Crammer SSEs, and the Vans. Fuck, they're old school Vans. But in order of what shoes I had, I got these first. My Dixie Bridges. I use these to. That's just from grip tape, but when I used to bomb hills, I used to put my foot down, or I still do now, but I used to just bomb hills, straight up bomb hills, and big hills as well, so that's what happened from that. The next set of shoes I got was some DC West Crammer SSEs. These are pretty good shoes. I really like these shoes at the time, and they came with the best insoles I've had. Then I've got the ones which I'm wearing now, the, DC Nigers. They are really, really good. They're my favourite pair of shoes so far. And got some Vans. So all these are DCs apart from these Vans. These ones, they don't have changeable insoles, unfortunately. That's why these aren't really my fave. They look really, really nice. Look-wise, these are my fave. Skate-wise, they're not. They're good for flat ground, but not for stairs, which I like to do. I'll probably end up buying a new pair of shoes and just having those ones for going out and other shoes for skating. But back to the magazines. I have Time magazine. My nan got me this. I have Ed's Ed Musicians magazine. I used to have a whole bunch of them. A load of them. Jeez. I've got a Spokes magazine. Another Spokes magazine. A Bulletin magazine. Let me put them upside down. I have an Adventure magazine. Another Adventure magazine. Another Adventure magazine. Another Adventure magazine. Another Adventure magazine. Once again,
another adventure magazine, and another adventure magazine, and another adventure magazine. And to add to that, I've got this tiny Vulcan one, so pretty sweet. I like reading them, but one day I'll end up cutting everything out and maybe making a collage. I'll just collect them and make a collage out of them over time. Or maybe when I get older and we move, because we're probably going to end up going to move out of this place. Or when I get older and have my own place, I'm going to take little posters out of each one of these, because the adventure magazines, a lot of them have their posters in them. But I take the posters out and put them all over a wall, which should be dope. But right now we're going to leave, going to drop Sophie off at a friend's house, come back. Not sure when I meet you up with say how. I've rang him twice and he hasn't answered, but I'll probably end up skating with him later. So just went down that hill, just put my foot down and slow down a bit. Dropped Sophie off at a friend's house, and she said there's a shortcut here, because we took a shortcut to get here. And she's like, Jack, there's an even faster shortcut. It's over here. And I was like, oh, okay. So I think this is the one she's talking about. She says it's by a green fence. Wet ass shoes. She said there's a field. Ah, I found the one she's on about. That field there. Ah, she didn't tell me it was muddy. Jesus, this is all waterlocked. Ah, thanks Sophie for bringing me to a waterlocked place. Just get a board without the trucks and wheels. Grass boarding. Come down the hill on just your board. If you have an odd board, you can do that. I don't know if that's an actual thing, but that's an idea which just popped into my head. Because I usually do that with boxes when I was younger. I was thinking, oh, cool skateboard, oh. Kill all mushrooms. Fuck yes. Oh my god, I know where we are. This is literally, I'm not gonna show you where it is because I'm literally behind Mitch's house. I just found the ultimate board slide spot. I'm gonna try this and we'll see how it goes.
It's hard to get out of. Pardon? Pardon? What? Okay.
You can't see my hand, but I pulled the middle finger at the guy. Fuck over there. Couldn't mind his own business. Tries to be a dick. Yeah. He's gonna call cops or something. If I continue to skate there, sitting there now watching, well, standing there watching me now. But apparently you're not allowed to skate. If someone's skating it before you, you can tell. I was like, they're not concreted in there, they're pushed in there. And I fucking like it. I'll come back later when he's not there. Or tomorrow. Come back tomorrow. This is a fucking big hill. Whoa, I just hit something. All I can say about that old guy that told me off is straight and utter dickhead. Old bloke had nothing better to do. He wasn't nice about it. He wasn't, oh, can you please not skate on that? He's like, oi, don't do that. You're not allowed to skate on that. And it's like, geez, fucking calm your shit, son. Well, not son, old fuck. Fucking go mental. Go back tomorrow just to piss him off, or maybe later. People like that are just wankers, you know. If they're nice about it, you just leave and leave it as that. When people are pure dickheads, you feel like pissing them off just because they're dickheads. Fucking, that guy needed to chill his shit. But now I'm at Pine Hill, on the back entrance, and gonna skate there. Or I might stop off and get something first. I know, I keep ringing him, but he doesn't answer, so we'll see. But at Pine Hill currently, gonna try and get a sesh. Now at Pine Hill, I'm gonna try kickflip the lip here. It's a lot bigger in real life, it doesn't seem that big in film, but I'm gonna set up the phone, try to land a kickflip over that, and let's see how many tries this will take me, or if I get it at all, so let's get started. Lucky I have my gloves. I had that.
that didn't take long. Lucky I had my gloves because, as you see, I scratched my hands a lot and cut them. So, that's done. So, just did them. I still haven't heard back from Sunhouse, so I'm gonna go home now, check Messenger, and see if he's able to hang. Probably not skate because I'm not really feeling it today, but maybe if he wants to.
So I'm home now. I've been waiting for Sunhouse for a while, and he messaged me on Messenger and saying that just like. As soon as I got home, I heard a ding on my iPad, but then I just went and got something to eat, and then I checked my iPad, and he said, oh, I can't skate, are you able to skate Salvation Army? And Salvation Army is pretty much where he lives, but I have to walk all the way there, and it's just over 2k's from where I live, so I have to go there, and I'm thinking, it's dark outside, I don't really want to go, and I said, no, I can't go. And I'm like, oh, crap, it's too dark for me to skate. And I said to him, next time, can you not ask me to hang out with you if you're not going to come? Because he's done this, like, a whole bunch of times. I was just sick of it. And then he's like, I didn't tell you I was going to hang out with you. I didn't say I was going to come. And I'm thinking, hold up, you did say you were going to come, because he said he's like, he called me, and he's like, yo, Jack, I'm like, yeah, because, and at this time, I was actually in the middle of a vlog, I was updating the vlog, and then he rang me, and he's like, yo, Jack, my little brother's going to his friend's house, so I'm gonna come over there, are you able to skate? And I said, yeah. And he's like, sweet, can we skate Pine Hill? And I was like, oh, okay, sure. And that's how pretty much what happened. And he said, oh, I never told you I was gonna come, but he told me, by the sounds of what he said, it sounded like he's gonna come. And he's like, I didn't tell you to wait for, and I'm like, I ain't got time for this, you've wasted enough of my time. And he said, I didn't tell you to wait for me. And it's like, I just waited for you because that's a normal thing to do, I'm not a dickhead. And then he's like, oh, well, I never told you I was going to skate Pine Hill. And I didn't even mention Pine Hill. Because when I was messaging, all I sent him was, I can't skate Salvation Army. It's too dark to skate. Don't offer me if you're not going to come. And I ain't got time for this. You've wasted enough of my time. Those are the only things which I mentioned. And he said, yeah, well, I never mentioned anything about Pine Hill. You're the one who mentioned it. But I never said any of that in the 4 messages which I sent him. So it's obvious that he did mention it. And I've actually got video proof on my phone of him saying it. Because, as I just said, I was updating the vlog and he called me on the iPad. But we kind of said a few personal things on the conversation. So I'm not going to put it on screen just for personal reasons. I don't really want to... I'm not a dickhead, I'm not going to invade his privacy and fucking put that all over YouTube. But, yeah, and then, we were just arguing for a little bit, and then we decided just to leave it as that. So, right now, I'm watching some John Hill, good old John Hill. Watch him, big inspiration. And, I'm pretty much just going to wrap up the video here. I'm not doing much tonight, but editing videos. I've edited this video so far, it's 26 minutes long, it's probably going to be like half an hour long or something like that. Pretty long video. I've cut down on a lot of the footage, but I'm just gonna be cleaning the house, editing videos, maybe playing guitar or something, and my mum will come home with dinner soon, so I'll just wrap it up here. And thanks for watching that. If you like that, hit the thumbs up button. If you're new to my channel, haven't already, subscribe, check out Knuckles' Facebook page in the description below. Till next time, peace out.